Survey import in ATLAS.ti 22 for Windows. If you conduct a survey that includes open-ended questions, you can import the results of the survey as an Excel file into ATLAS.ti. It does not matter which survey software you are using. A wizard will guide you through the process of importing the data. ATLAS.ti makes an educated guess as to which columns in your Excel file might be document attributes, document groups, or coded document contents. Quantitative data like gender, family status, etc. can be imported as document groups. These typically are single-answer questions. If respondents can select multiple answers, ATLAS.ti creates a document group from each value. The default answer separator is a comma. You can change this to a semicolon. The answers to open-ended questions will become the document content. Each question is automatically coded with the header. If you insert two colons between the question number and the question in the Excel file, the question will automatically be added as a code comment. The question number will be used as a code label. Here we want to use the information from columns A and B for the document name. The following questions are all single-answer questions. For the question about sources of happiness, respondents could select from multiple answers. We therefore set this question as a multi-answer question. The next two questions are open-ended questions about reasons for and against having children. Click Import when you have set all column types. Let's take a look at the imported data. In the Document Manager, you see all of the document groups that were created based on the single and multi-answer questions. When asked about the sources of happiness, Sandra chose only one of the answer options, while Peter chose two, family and friends. The pre-coded document looks as follows. When you double-click on a code, you can inspect the code comment. Remember, it can automatically be created if you insert two colons between the question number and the question. Here you see the automatically created codes in the Code Manager. They are contained in a folder called Survey Questions. Also here, you see the inserted comments based on the full question. In the following, we would like to show you an import based on a survey generated in SurveyMonkey. We use the respondent ID as a document name, but ignore the collector ID. For the survey you see here, there's a lot of quantitative information, and there are multiple options as to whether we could use this information as document groups or as data. In the end, it depends on what aspects you may want to relate with one another. What you often find in SurveyMonkey surveys is that two rows are used as a header. If this is the case, you need to adjust the header rows from 1 to 2. The Excel that you exported from SurveyMonkey might look like this one. ATLAS.ti can handle matrix questions, as well as ranking questions. Let's take a look at what the imported file looks like. This is the body of the text. Some of the single-answer questions were added as document content, so they can later be related to the document groups. This is how the answers to the ranking questions were imported. These are the codes that were generated to code the data. The answers to the matrix questions are coded by a category with subcodes. A possible next step could be to look for concepts in the pre-coded data and to add more fine-grained coding. We've included the link to the video on concept search below.